my car.
It smells like shit,
but it tastes delicious.
Get back to work, you slacker.
https://www.twitch.tv/08hz.
Sláinte and happy Tuesday, everybody. Tuesday is coming. Did you bring your coat? Yeah. Nothing special tonight. I've got a collection of orphaned pain waters from various 12 packs, so I just grabbed a couple out of that. You've got just a strawberry watermelon. This is why not. And then for dessert, we have and orange cream buble. My last of each. Yeah, for now. Well, welcome in, everybody. Welcome in. I don't know if my connection's a little wonky. It took those two songs in their entirety. In the pre-stream warm-up in order to get links posted in Discord saying, you know, notifications that I'm going live. So, I don't know if stuff's squirrely right now, but I guess we'll find out. Everything looks fine on the old iPad monitor. So your guess is as good as mine. But I hope we're all doing well. Waddy says it cut out for a second. Okay, well, I guess we'll keep an eye on it. Waddy!
Incredible Waddy just re-enlisted for 40 months. Fuck it. We'll do it
four,
live.
Four... I don't know which dirt... 4-0... No, that's 0-4. Four... Is that right? 4-0... 40 months. Thank you, Waddy, for 40 months.
Woo!
Well, that chat's gotten ahead of me here.
Whoa. CP Geek 2 just shared one bit. We'll sleep when we're dead.
But we'll die if we don't sleep! Waddy's here. Phoenix is here. Heard the Mexican pizza song this time. Chris the Lamp is here as well. Welcome in. Why is it... Okay, now it... Now it wants to play another dang ad?
I'm a gummy bear, gummy bear.
I just let it play one. Unless somebody came in and snoozed it. I hope you didn't, because I wanted it to play before we started. Oh, well, regardless, we're going to have an ad. Because it has to play it anyway. So, or maybe I accidentally did. I don't know. All right, we got 30 seconds before it starts. So let's see. Let me see if I can catch a chat in that time. And Waddy's already redeeming Guide the Raid to DJ Nikki, who's doing a birthday subathon. So yeah, sure. We can raid over there when we're done. Not a problem. Wednesday is coming. No, it's been hot as balls to CB Geek. CB Geek! All right, Phoenix says we're good. CB Geek is pulling out some squirrely wrath, and with that squirrely wrath, it is now ad time. You snoozed it because you didn't want it to be a pre-roll ad? I guess I don't understand the differences. Or maybe it's because I don't know. Maybe it's different than me clicking play an ad. And go for the ad. It's not telling me it's rolling the ad yet. It just says ad starting soon. All right, whatever. I'm going to manually play a 60-second one. So BRB, everybody who unfortunately has to see it. All right, 60 seconds. Next auto run ad is reduced by one. All right, well, so we're in an ad break. We're not going to say or do anything really until the ad break is over. My sorries, everyone. My apologies. They're getting so pushy. Getting so dang pushy. And I know most of us are subbed here, so it doesn't really matter to us. But for the people that aren't, you know, I don't want them to miss anything. We got 20 seconds left. We'll just run down the clock for them. Ten seconds. Actually, the two tickers aren't even in time with each other. One says 3 seconds. One says 6. So I don't know what to believe anymore. Ad break ended. Your community is back. Well, welcome back, everybody who had to be bombarded with advertisements. But welcome back, everybody. Let's see. Where were we? Fates is here. Howdy, howdy, howdy. How's everyone doing tonight? I've not been too great. Been pretty nauseous and dehydrated, but got a great grocery run done. Nice. Hope y'all are doing well. Well, keep drinking that. Keep drinking water, man. But also, don't drink too much water because you're going to flush all your salts out. So sometimes, as gross as it sounds, a beneficial thing to do is just put a little bit of regular salt into your water. It'll help you retain some of it. Because that's the one mistake a lot of people make, because they're like, I'm dehydrated, so they just drink water, plain water, and then they end up dehydrating themselves even more, because it's just, yeah, because they flush all the salts out of your system. And then you get cramps, and that's not fun. No snoozy here, snoozy because they want to be pro. Okay, I think we're getting there. Fate's got an ad for Porinal 3.5 millimeter headphones. That's nothing I'm familiar with. And go for ad. I'm wondering if my message... Yeah, I'm seeing your messages. I hadn't gotten that far yet. Yeah, streamers apparently find that pre-roll ads where people see an ad before coming onto the streams get people to click off more often than other ads. That's why I'm trying to, like, before... When it's still in the starting soon, I'm just trying to, like, manually run a 60-second. But it took me so long to put everything in Discord that it was already, like, starting an ad. I'm like, oh, I'll just let it do it. Instead of, you know, me doing a manual
1 minute one.
The subs are going to be $6 instead of $5. I know. It's stupid. And just a reminder for people that do like to gift subs and everything. You will save yourself money if you do it in a browser and not on a mobile device, i.e. not on an Android phone, not on an iPhone, because they charge you more to pay marketplace fees. But if you're in a browser, you don't have to pay those. And it's like an extra buck. So it adds up. Just the more you know, because knowledge is power. I finally got tired of not being able to breathe normally, so I decided to go to the walk-in clinic on your lunch break today to find out that the walk-in clinic you've been going to for many years is permanently closed. Aw, man. So from the parking lot, you called your PCP. And asked if there were any appointments today or tomorrow, because I'm gone on Thursday. And the only appointment available is at 7:45 tomorrow. And yours truly is not a morning person. Wake up for work at 9. Oh, man, that sucks. Are you going to go anyway? Just, you know, suck it up and do it because health? Or are you like, no! On principle. Oh, yeah. Yeah, Brondo's got electrolytes. Yeah, it's what plants crave. Fates has got two nice lemonades. Lemonade and ginger ale helps. Does carbonation? I don't think it's liquid, so you're hydrating from it. I don't think there's anything negative per se from carbonation. If something is caffeinated, it will technically dehydrate you because caffeine is a diuretic. But carbon dioxide, you're still getting liquid. I mean, you're still getting it with sodas and stuff, too, but, like, yeah. Don't want to do a mom, but some options are better. Oh, I hear you. Yeah, they charge you more on mobile. Yeah, I'm going to go anyway because health. Well, that's good, at least. You're hoping for an albuterol inhaler minimally. That's one of the two that I used to have to take as a kid when my asthma was really a thing. Although... I had two of them. My inhalers were originally one called Alupent and Vanceril. And you always did this one and then this one. But then something got weird with the Alupent and it not being safe or I don't know. I looked it up at one point and then they changed me to Albuterol and the Vanceril. I didn't like the Alupent or the Albuterol because it tasted kind of bitter, but I kind of like the Vanceril because it had a weird, almost sweetness to it. I mean, that's me being an inhaler connoisseur as an asthmatic child. And it was better than having to suck on a nebulizer for half an hour every night. So, yeah. Carbonation isn't recommended for people with acid reflux, but otherwise it's fine. The more you know. And don't punch your microphone. CB Geek's been previously diagnosed with exercise-induced asthma, and the albuterol inhaler helps in those situations. But getting to the bottom of things would be best. Yeah, I agree. It's been going on for a long time now. Well over... Yeah, man. And it's never been a regular problem for me before, so there may be something else at play. But... So, yeah, I mean, it couldn't hurt. And I know there's, like, some not COVID sickness that's gone around in the last 6 months or so that has brought with it, like, a persistent just dry cough. I don't know if that's related to this, but, like, just a dry cough that will not go away, but it's not COVID. But it's something else. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. We're just getting out of tree pollen season here, and while it spared my sinuses this year, I think that's where my arthritis flare came from, which is still not entirely resolved, but it's minimal enough at this point that it's not all that bothersome. I just, like, I can't, like, bend, like, curl one of my toes down like I normally can. Like, I can on my left, but not on my right. Because, like, yeah. It's almost like the joint is stuck on itself. So, I don't bend it that way. But I'm fine. At this point, I'll put up with it. Mouse update. I either had a mouse nibbling on your thumb at 3:45 last night, or a dream that I did and the dream woke me up. Ah! Yeah, to get them fucks out of there. They're looking for a new food source, and they think it might be you. I just saw one run out of my bedroom for the first time in several days. What buttholes? Marketplace fees for something like this is it just buying the subs and stuff from the app? I'm just wondering if that increase happens on every sale. So there's the flat rate for a sub. Which to get that flat rate, you have to buy gifted subs and, you know, whatever, buy your subs in a browser. That's the flat rate. But if you were to buy them either on an iPhone in the app or on Android in the app, there's an extra dollar tacked onto it for every sub. Because Google takes its cut from the Play Store, and Apple takes their cut through their App Store. So, but in the browser, there's no marketplace to take a cut. So, well, in like 2 days, I'm going to go walk for like 30 miles a day, because that's apparently what fun is in the oppressive Florida sunshine. Thank you, they really are buttholes. Anytime you buy on your phone, you pay Google/Apple for using their platform for payment processing because capitalism. Yep. That's what capitalism. Dang it. That's what it should do. That's what it should be. Exclamation point. Capitalism should just say, dang it! Exclamation point. There it is. That's the command. Swiggity Swooty!
Now the panda booty just cheered one bit. Swiggity Swooty.
Swiggity Swooty, she's backing up that booty. Nice to see you, Mare Bear. How are things going with you? I hope things are all right. I all capsed it. Mare Bear! On Wadi's channel, it's a link to her wares. Oh! Well, maybe we'll change it at some point, but for now, I just like capitalism. Dang it! Oh, but speaking of wares and capitalism and everything, I got an email that Stream Elements is shutting down their merch store. So, and it's soon. It's very soon. They are referring us to a different third-party store if we want to do merch stuff. So, I mean, I'm going to jump through those hoops, but, like, it's not something I wanted to deal with right now. So, yeah. So if you're, and again, I'm not, they're like, everything should just port right over, but I mean, with port overs, there's always something that gets lost. So if there's something, if there's some bit of my merch that you really, really wanted, you want to make sure you get it, then I would, like, in the next week or so, if you can. Again, you don't have to. You don't have to. I only have a merch store because the stuff makes me laugh. And I like to wear it. But I would recommend getting on in there if there's something you'd like. And I'll let everybody know when the port over is done and all this other stuff. So, just another thing I have to deal with. Do you already have a new back-end producer? No, they're bringing in a third-party organization company that we can opt in, and they will transfer our store to this other company. Who knows how well that's going to work? I don't know. So I'll try it, but at least my merch is simple enough that I can pretty easily recreate it if need be. I'd rather not, but I probably could. Just edited the link to use your new GoFundMe. All right, yep. And there's a lot happening right now, and Rickshaw Tom is going back to Ninja Worlds. So if you'd like to support him in that endeavor by throwing him a dollar or so to make him do pull-ups for each dollar, I think that's what he's doing, then follow the link and give him a hand. I'm also going on a big trip this week for a week. I don't have a GoFundMe, but at this point I feel like I should. I'm not gonna. But we'll get into that in a bit, because some plans had to change. Let's see, where are we? A lot of stuff happened here. I just want to make sure I'm not missing anything. Capitalism, dang it. Mayor Bear's doing okay. Okay, nice to hear that. Maybe another for communism in the comments as a comrade. Fuck, I was about to sign up for them. I'm leaving my 13-hour shift I pulled. Ooh, 13. Oh, jeez. Well, get that bag, Mayor Bear. Get that bag. But, ugh. Glad you're on your way out, though. Holy shit, it works here, too? They seem like high quality. Yeah, and especially, like, the most recent ones. Like, the Yeats a Pizza shirt is, like, of all the merch I've gotten, was great. The quality of it, the print quality is fantastic. So, and of course, now that, like, it's settled to a point where, like, whatever. We'll roll with it. It gives me a chance to do better merch designs. I hear you. Because mine's also kind of cluttered up
Chris
at this point.
Just cheered 10 bits. All my bags are packed. I'm ready to go. I'm standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye, but the dawn is breaking. It's early morn. The taxi's waiting. He's blowing his horn already. I'm so lonesome I could die.
Trashly, punctuation, breathe, girl, breathe.
We've tried nothing and we're all out of ideas.
Speaking of breathing, ba 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 boo boo ba 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 boo 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 ba 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 boo boo ba 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 boo 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 ba 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 boo boo ba 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 boo 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 ba 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 boo boo ba ba boo boo ba ba boo. All right, still scrolling through here, making sure I'm not missing anything. Better merch designs. Just added the link to use the new GoFundMe. The thing that sucks about that stream store the most, because it screws up so many people. Usually YouTubers make their own companies to avoid. Yeah, but and I've thought about that, but the downside to that is you have to hold inventory. It's cheaper, but you have to buy it and then wait for people to buy it from you, and you have to, like, rent a storage unit or something, just to hold on to boxes and boxes of merch that you hope people pay for. Whereas what I like about how Stream Elements worked is it was print on demand. You paid a little more you paid quite a bit more per unit, but you only had to order one. So in that regard, you know, I liked it. I also will be having to re-examine the number of I don't want to blame inflation, because it's always been this way, but just the number of snoots per free merch redemption, doing the math on it and on some of these and on some of the things, like it's a year plus of what my cut of subs are to send someone free merch. So it's like sub for a year, you get all your money back in a form of free merch. I don't know. I have to do numbers. And it depends on what this new company's going to charge as well. So just a heads up that those redemption amounts are probably going to be changing once everything is settled with this new company. Because it's nice to get my merch out there. Breaking even for a year on it is kind of sucky, but like, whatever. I just missed where I was in chat. Stream store. Okay, that's where we were. If you need other merch options, let me know. I'm aware of a few with good reviews. Oh, really? Some plans have to change? Do tell. You did it, Aruk. You saved $70. What? How did I save $70? I want $70. The quality has been really fantastic on your merch. I'm glad I switched up what I was doing with the tack fit. The blankets especially. I do really like the blankets. I think they've been the sleeper item in the store. I mean, I've sold more t-shirts than anything else, but also, like, I don't think the t-shirts...
Whoa. CP Geek 2 just chaired
especially
one
the
bit.
Old ones.
$1 can buy many peanuts.
Explain how. like, especially, like, my first generation of merch, pretty much all of my own, like, first generation of merch stuff, I've worn it out. Like, most of the graphic is gone, and it was well-loved and well-worn. So, I couldn't do a pull-up. Don't have good enough grip strength. I could do laps in a pool, but how would I prove that? Blankets! Moody Abigail! Welcome in. Thanks for the heckin' lurk. I appreciate it. Trashly is a slutty horse. She's learned proper breath control. As like, my peripheral vision read ahead in that sentence, I didn't think it was going to say breath control. I thought it was going to be another B-word control of... something in regard to Trashly being a slutty horse. True inventory is the exact issue. That's why starting up game stores is so hard. Well, that it's in general, any sort of retail operation that you start, holding inventory is the big expense and a big concern. 150K? 200K? I don't know. I'd have to, again, once I know what prices are in this new store, I'm going to have to crunch numbers. Oh, using the flight voucher. Hey, that was $75. Thank you very much. Blankets are primo. Blankets so soft. Yeah, my snoot hoodie has some cracks in the design. She's basically just a slutty horse living her best life. All right, and I've officially caught up with chat. CB Geek, closing in on a quarter mil, but you're currently sitting at around the mileage my OG Civic got to before everything just went to hell with it. It was about 225,000 miles. Wadi has 170.6K. Nice. Everyone showing off their riches. It's appreciated. It is. Some slight changes in my travel plans. So the biggest one is due to the fact that Seattle's really fucking expensive and not having proper scheduling to meet up with Miss Lacey, I'm not staying the night in Seattle but I'm still going to Seattle. I'm doing Seattle as a day trip. So just in doing that, staying, like, having my overnight be back in Portland instead, that saves me $175. So I will still go to Seattle as intended. I'll spend the day there, do some touristy things, but then that night I'll take the Amtrak back and then spend the night in Portland again. And again, that saves me $175 just doing that. Cause I'd still be training back. And so that's that. And a big part of this also is like all that fiasco and realization and damages come to life and everything in regards to the Prius has got me like, I got to scale this back. Best some things I had already booked, some things I hadn't. So scaling back, saving money where and how I can on this trip is kind of essential right now. So $175 saved by going back to Portland same day and just staying in the same hotel. Because Portland, I get it. The hotel I'm staying at's $100 a night. And in Seattle, it would have been almost $300 for a single night. No fooling. Unless I was like 20 to 30 miles outside of Seattle. So that ain't happening. So Fates, last Friday, I had an appointment to go get my winter tires taken off and summer tires put on. Not a big deal. But the shop folks came out and they're like, we cannot do this because your car is no longer safe to put on a lift. The lift spots, like where you jack them up from, have rusted out completely. So your car cannot be put on a lift. So we are refusing service, which they're absolutely in their right to do. So since a car can't be put on a lift, it's kind of hard to fix things. So I got to kind of, figure out what I'm going to do in that regard. But I had already made some of these travel plans and everything that I'm going on. So like I already bought my San Francisco to Chicago train ticket. So regardless of all this, and I had bought my first flight between Hartford, Atlanta, and Denver. Like that was bought, and then getting on the train on Sunday in San Francisco was bought. So another thing that I had mulled around and I'd mentioned on Phoenix's stream was going to Connecticut tomorrow and staying in a hotel next to the airport to save having to drive at night. That's one of the things I didn't actually book, and I'm not going to do it. So that'll save me another $80 there. And the reason I'm not, I rechecked my boarding pass, and for some reason I had it in my head that my flight went out at 8 a.m., but my flight actually goes out at 10 a.m., so I've got an extra 2 hours there. So that's enough to swing my decision back in the other direction. So I have rehearsal tomorrow night. If we can optimistically finish up our rehearsal around 8, like we did yesterday, then I can get back home 9-ish. If I can be in bed between 9 and 10 and actually sleep, I'm going to try to lay off the caffeine tomorrow too, just to make sure I can. If I'm out the door here by around 4 a.m., like 4:30, that should get me to Bradley, like 8:30. They recommend Bradley themselves recommend 90 minutes for a flight, so that seems maybe sufficient. Of course, I can always drive faster to get there, but so yeah. So I'm gonna get up and get out here at 4 a.m. Thursday morning. But part of why I was late starting stream tonight was I'm like I need to get some laundry done because when I get home from work tomorrow, not home from work, home from rehearsal, it's going to be somewhere between 9 and 10 o'clock. So I'm not really going to have time to fart around. I kind of have to have everything, if I can, packed tonight. And I don't know if I'm going to, because my shit's in the washer and not in the dryer. Yeah, so saving like $81-$82, not staying next to the airport tomorrow night, just driving home, sleep my last sleep in my own bed for a week. Let's say I get to sleep at 10. That's 6 hours. I can operate on 6 hours. That's not a problem. Also, I'm gonna be on some decently long flights, or at least one decently long flight. So I can nap there if need be.
Whoa. CP Geek 2 just shared 1 bits. We'll sleep when we're dead.
Oh, didn't that happen to one of Mom's old cars? I remember hearing that the cars went up, but the wheels stayed on. That and the mechanics pushing the car uphill. Well, that's the problem with the Northeast and road salt. And that's the main reason, well, one of the main reasons why I don't drive the Genesis in the winter, because of what road salt does to cars. But in that regard, the Prius is like damn near 20 years old. So it did its job. I've already kept it alive. I've already put way too many thousands of extra dollars into it to keep it alive. So this is just the thing that's like, no. If I can fix the grindy noise, then I can maybe limp it along for another year. And if I saw the grindy noise, buy a second set of rims, like either at a junkyard or just the cheapest things I can find to, cause I got these new tires. It's got, and then just jack it up myself and then just cycle them off. Cause there's other points you can jack, but like most commercial lifts are just arms and they go to specific spots. But if you're just using a floor jack, you can like put a piece of wood on a jack and you can lift from the oil pan. You can lift from the differential, et cetera, et cetera. There's other points you can lift. So we'll see if I can fix that noise, then I'll probably try to limp it along for another year. If I can't, then out of sheer curiosity, I did a, what's the term? Pre-qualification for an auto loan, and they seem to think that I could afford a $91,000 car. Fuck that. And I'm balking at like $20,000 on another car. But I digress. Is it inspected for the year? No, it's not. It ran out in February. But Vermont changed to new inspection stickers that are only ever yellow. And now, like a lot of other states, they're down near the dash. And for the most part, well, it's harder for cops to see. And for the most part, like 9 times out of 10, they're not going to pull you over just for an inspection. But if you're pulled over for something else and they see you're not inspected, they'll tack it on. So that's that sort of thing. 91K. Yeah, that's like, what, 3,000 a month payments? Yeah, seriously. That's house money, 91K, not car money. Is there a point you can jack? Oh, yeah. Are you going to stream from the train if possible? So I'm on the... So cycling back around that. Since I'm not staying the night in Seattle, but the train I'm taking back leaves later than my stream would have normally started. So I will still be able to stream from Seattle if I do like an hour or so stream there right before I get on the train. So, because of the time change and everything, it would be my normal stream time. So we'll see. And then the following Tuesday, I will be in Chicago, hopefully having arrived from my cross-country trek on the old train. So that Tuesday, we'll be able to do our, week from today, we'll be streaming from Chicago. So I saved that Seattle hotel money. I saved Hartford hotel money. I've booked a cheaper hotel in Chicago, which saved like $40. The only thing I haven't done yet is I haven't booked the one in San Francisco, which I'll probably end up doing tomorrow. It's just like logistics and trying to figure all this crap out. I mean, I'm only in San Francisco for 14 hours, and that's the thing. But I digress. So, yeah, trying to save money where I can. I think I tallied it up because I was going over it at work. And as it stands, I've managed to knock about $300 off of this, which is pretty good. It's pretty good. It's coming up to near like a third of the cost of the trip. So anything else I can knock off and then just keep like my per diem for meals and stuff to a relatively dull roar, then I should be all right. I should be all right. I'll enjoy myself regardless. It's going to be fun. 91K, that would take me a decade. Oh yeah, but then the train portion would probably be too dark to see anything cool out the window from Seattle. Yeah. I remember getting pulled over in Milton just feet from my driveway, and I was only coming back from Hannaford. He claimed he couldn't see my sticker. Alec had just gotten it inspected. Fucking Milton cops. I mean, I've seen them time and time again. Literally just, they troll up and down, and whoever it is in front of them, they'll pull over. Like, they'll roll the dice and hope that that they can get them for something. Then they'll just turn around and go this way, and they'll pull that person over. And then they'll turn around again and pull that person over. They're really just playing the numbers game. But yeah, bull honky. Definitely eat on the dining car of the train. We'll see. Then he continued to scold me for using my phone when it's in the hands-free phone. He was bored and trying to make his... Yeah, exactly. Locals do that around here, too. Not gonna lie, I think Seattle is that much more expensive for the sole reason that it's the most well-known city in the... I mean, depending on what you call the area, not necessarily. Because, like, there's Seattle. There's Vancouver, Washington. There's Vancouver, Canada. There's Portland. There's a lot going on there, but it's also just... There's a lot of IT stuff there. There's a lot of money that lives there. So that has pushed the cost of everything up. So. It's not just that it's well known. It's that there's a lot going on there. Seattle's probably more well known because it's cool and grunge. But yeah, I looked at a couple day trip possibilities. Well, not day trip, but like, you know, things I can do while I'm there. One thing that I saw that looks pretty cool is like, there's a company that does guided tours of the underground old Seattle. Like, there was old Seattle, and they just put a roof on it and built new Seattle. So, like, they take you down into old Seattle, like, underground, like, as above, so below. So, that might be fun. And then I also probably most definitely will do the biggest tourist thing and go up the Space Needle. Because why not? And it makes me think of The Simpsons. And then there's a couple other things. But again, I'm gonna figure that out on the train ride up. Because again, the whole point of this trip is the travel to get to these places is paramount. And then as I'm getting there, I'll figure out just what the hell I'm gonna do. Like, I had so many people being like, well, when you're in this place, you need to do this and this and this. And I'm like, no! Thanks. No. Oh, but can I tell you some things to do? No. That was a conversation I had today. And I mean, it's completely whack-ass different from how pretty much everyone else travels. And I understand that it's weird and it doesn't make any sense. But, like, it's kind of how I want to do it. I don't want to be following rules or an itinerary other than when my departure and arrival times are. I just want to be able to fuck around and find out. Although the one thing that I am, like, I will stand by is Lacey telling me do not go to Third Street or Third, whatever the third road is. Do not go there. So I will not go there. So I'm boycotting the Nathan's hot dog eating contest this year. No Joey Chestnut to eat 70-something hot dogs is bad for them. I also don't have ESPN, so I can't watch it anyway. Well, those are both good reasons. So it's not that he didn't qualify. It's that there's a sponsor issue or something. That's just stupid. But meanwhile, Pittsburgh people speeding like 20 over the limit and they're left alone. I think the borough leaders are pushing for more patrolling because they're going bankrupt. I should have changed my registration to PA within a month of being here. Still have Vermont plates. They don't care. Everybody still have a Connecticut plate and I've been here 3+ years. Can't figure out how to get my title yet, so I haven't been able to switch it. Nobody cares. It's not that weird. It does make sense. I think I just had an interesting thought experiment. I thought of 4 U.S. cities that fit the 4 elements. Chicago is air, even though some would say whatever, wherever JFK is. That's New York. GCV would be Earth. Grand Canyon Valley. Since GameCube is the Earth example, but Vegas could also work. It's also Oasis in the stupid Mojave. Seattle is water, self-explanatory, and either LA or in San Francisco or a city in Florida would be fire. Well, what I'm told, San Francisco is temperate and more like Vermont in terms of weather. At least that's what my friend who lives there has said. Like, it's not like Seattle, it's not like LA, you're gonna go there and swelter. It's more like Vermont. So I trust her judgment on that. Or a city in Florida would be fire. One pair is always on fire. No two people are not on fire. Do not got there. So that means you got to find out why. No, I think I'll take Miss Lacey's advice on that. Joey Chestnut is endorsing Impossible Meech. Oh, okay. Well, seems to be working out well for him. That's why he can't do the Nathan's hot dog eating contest. Whatever, he's won it so many times. Let someone else have it. He can go win something else. Joey's getting paid tons of money. I'm sure he's gonna be. Yeah, exactly. Grand Canyon Village. I guess I don't know what that is. Yeah, apparently if you compete in the Nathan's hot dog eating contest, you agree not to compete in a competitor's contest or sponsor name brands, but you can compete in fucking corporate bullshit. Or like how Vince had that rule in profession that you could never mention another the name of another organization that did wrestling. You could never mention another wrestler who was not currently under contract with him. They did not exist. Once they walked out the doors, it was as if they never existed at all. They were gone. Corporate shit. Oh, well. Shit is fucking complicated here. You got to go to a notary, fill out a form to request the title for whatever bank you're making payments to. Then they send the title to the notary. Then you go to the DMV and get it actually changed. Yeah. That's one thing I'll say about Vermont, though, is they had that nickname of America's DMV for a reason. Although they did restrict some of those things that made Vermont DMV stuff accessible to the nation, but oh well. At least we don't have to get fucking notary shit. I still hate the goddamn inspection system as a fucking racket and extortion, but whatever, what are you gonna do? Yeah, that seems reasonable to me, Lamp. I endorse a scientific method. Number one, fuck around. Number two, find out. Number three, write it down. That's the important one, and most people forget. Unfortunately, my registration expires end of the month, and I can't Uber if it's expired, so this is the month I guess I change it. Goodbye, Vermont plates. Adios. I mean, you can do the classy thing and turn them into decorations. Then Bret Hart flipped him off after the Montreal screwjob. Yep. I keep hearing Cali being on fire, but then I hear people saying it's not the case. Well, no, they went through a multi-year drought, so it was very dry, and a lot of it was on fire. So that was indeed a thing. But the last year or so, they have gotten the rain and snow that they've so desperately needed, so it's not really burning anymore. And again, that's more Southern California, which is more inhospitable. Northern California is like a whole other ecosystem. You want to get personalized plates? Yeah, you should. You should. Oh, and we're caught up. Well, yeah, in terms of the travel and everything, those are the changes I've made. Save what money I can, but, you know, still doing the damn trip. Because that's not changing. So that's the big thing there. And I'll do my best along the way to post to my socials and keep people updated what I'm doing. Apparently, there's a handful of people that want me to document this trip from my perspective as an introverted person traveling by myself. So I may do that maybe, and along the way, especially on the train, I may write like a YouTube essay script about everything and then just not do much, if any, like talking to the camera, just like filming everything there and then doing it all voiceover. We'll see. Just whatever is easier, because, you know, your boy's got a lot of time. Gonna say Kabunda, my fursona, or Kandra, my fursona name. Ha 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 ha. VT, US's DMV. Our actual DMV saved so much time of my life, and I only had to go for myself once. Well, it's that the big thing, how that came about, is Vermont will let you register a car. Well, there's two things. They'll let you register a car even if you don't live in Vermont. And they'll let you register a car that you don't have the actual title for. They will take a bill of sale on a car that's a certain age and will then turn around and issue you a title once you've registered it. So that's how people in a lot of other states, like, you know, someone's like, oh, I got an old car that's been in a barn for 40 years. I don't have any paperwork. And a lot of states, they will not let you register a car if you don't have a title. But a lot of old cars, people can't put back on the road because they don't have the paperwork for it. So what's called the Vermont loophole, which I actually think the last legislative session they closed, which is absolute bullshit, let people, again, use a bill of sale as proof of ownership and not requiring them to be a Vermont resident to register a vehicle, so that, you know, you could buy some barn car that's been in there for 40 years. Send that to the Vermont DMV. They'll send you back Vermont plates and a Vermont title for this car, because the title is optional. You don't have to get one, but you can pay for one and they'll give you one. And then they can take that Vermont title and then say they're in Kentucky or Tennessee or Oregon, and then they can take that Vermont title and then register the car in their state. So that's where that came from. NoCal is verdant. Ooh, that's a nice word. That's our word of the day. Verdant! Ah! Maybe I should... You could read... Assuming they didn't close the loophole, but... I mean, you could. It's like almost $80 a year. So I don't know if that makes it worthwhile, but you could. And you can use your current address in the place where you live. Assuming they didn't close the loophole. But... And that's how my dad got swindled out of his Jetta. They traded it for a broken lawnmower, then sold it at a cheap dealership in Rutland without the title. Ugh. The other time was with mom. She would not let me stay in the car in the summer. Hated it at the time, but she saved me from heat stroke, probably. Heat stroke or migraines via boredom. What do you choose? I never had a problem going to the DMV. But I also work for the government now, so... I mean, yeah, you gotta just kind of sit there and wait your turn. But it's like going to the doctor's office or anything, or getting tires put on your car. You just kind of got to sit there and wait your turn. And as long as you're prepared, everything goes fine. Once it's your turn, you're in and out pretty quick. Verdant is connected to vert, one of the root words that created Vermont. Know what I mean, vert? But yeah, so we're caught up on the chats. We're not going to go much longer. Cause again, if I know what's good for me, I will pack my bag tonight so that when I get home from rehearsal tomorrow, somewhere between 9 and 10 PM, it's all done and I can just kind of go to bed, cause I'm going to have to get up again around 4 a.m. on Thursday to drive to Connecticut to take that first flight. Which again, we'll go over the itinerary for folks that may not know. I'm taking a big trip. It's absolutely stupid and ridiculous, but I'm taking it. So on Thursday, leaving my house around 4 a.m. to drive to Bradley International in Connecticut for a flight out at 10 a.m., which will take me to Atlanta, where I will have a 4-hour layover. But also, since I'll be back in Atlanta, well, two things. One, let's hope the fuel doesn't fall out of my aircraft again. And two, I can go back to the bougie Centurion lounge and get myself free lunch. So I will do that again as well. And then I fly, knock on wood, from Atlanta to Denver, where there's a 2 to 3 hour layover. And from Denver, I then fly on to Portland, Oregon. And that's all in one day. So I'm getting into Portland roundabouts like midnight West Coast time. So that's like 3 a.m. US time. And then get not a whole lot of sleep. I have a choice on trains though. Ideally, what I'm going to do is there's a 6:45 a.m. train to Seattle. Ideally, that's the one I'm going to be on. It'll get me in Seattle at 10 a.m. But there's another one that's like $10 or $11 more that leaves at 8:30, I believe, and gets me there around 12:30. So we'll see how hard it is to get my ass out of bed. But regardless, I will spend the day doing Seattle things, and we'll have ourselves a little Seattle stream on Friday. And then I will take the train back to Portland, where I will spend my second night in my same hotel room and everything, so I can leave my stuff there. I don't have to carry my laptop and stuff around Seattle, so that'll be nice. And then I'll get to sleep in. I'll get to, and this will be Saturday, I'll get to sleep in and everything. I may even be able to catch the first hour or so of WWE Clash at the Castle before I have to exit my hotel. And then 6 o'clock, I believe, I have to be at PDX for my flight to San Francisco. And then I'll be in San Francisco for about 14 hours. The only thing I really have to do is I have to get from the airport in San Francisco to the train station, which is technically not in San Francisco. It's in Emeryville, but I'll either Uber or whatever. And then either that night, probably that night, I'll have to find myself a convenience store or something, or order delivery to my hotel of like drinks and snacks and stuff that I'm going to take on the train. Because then the next morning my train leaves Emeryville at like 8:30 or so. And then I'll be on the train for almost 60 hours. And then Tuesday afternoon, I will arrive in Chicago. And then I just have to get myself from the Union Station in Chicago to Chicago O'Hare, because the hotel I'm staying at is like right next to O'Hare. And then I'll be in Chicago for Tuesday night. We will have our stream from there next week. And then Wednesday morning, I'm basically taking my return flight home. And this is the one flight out of all these that I'm not taking Frontier. It's kind of like when I did Puerto Rico. I ended up, when I came back from Puerto Rico, I paid regular rate and took a different airline. And this time, just because if I could have done Frontier back, but I would have had to spend another night and it would have been in Orlando. And I'm like, again, with the whole saving money thing, it's like, I don't want to be out another night. At this point, I'll have gotten off the train and another night in a hotel, you know, after spending two nights on a train in a coach seat. And then everything, I'm like, I'm sure at that point I'm just gonna wanna go home. So this time I'm taking Spirit. So if we thought Frontier was fun, hoo boy, we're taking Spirit. And we're going from Chicago to Myrtle Beach, and then from Myrtle Beach, after like a 2.5 hour layover, we're going to Hartford. So we'll get into Hartford like 2 PM, I believe. And depending on if there's any delays or anything, I'm hoping to build in enough time to swing by Adong before I head on home, because when I scoot back up, I'm going to be going right to rehearsal Wednesday night. So, and that's the week I'm going to have. All right, let's see. I got to catch up and chat again, and then there's one other thing we got to do, and then we're going to marb real quick. So let me see here. Song and marbs. Vert and Mont
is like a wiener.
Oh, it is?
Sometimes it gets hard for no reason.
Mm-hmm.
But it won't stay hard forever.
Ah! Vert and Mont. Yeah, yeah. Exactly. That's where Vermont came from. It's French. I like to wait for my turn, and when they say my letter number combo, I yell out, bingo! In an old lady voice. If the fuel falls out of the plane, then you get another voucher. Yeah, but then my flight through to Oregon might fall through for that day, and I would have really no other way to get there. And also, to save money, every hotel I've booked is a prepay no refund booking, which may bite me in the ass, but it's freaking cheaper to do it that way. So your boy's rolling the dice there. For some reason, I thought Chicago. Is that the return? What you doing in the rain capital of the I am doing nothing. I am traveling. That is it. I am just going for the sake of going. I'm going because it's there. It starts at 11 Pacific. I think it starts at 1 if you watch the pre-show, I think. It starts, like, the regular event starts at 2, I believe. So, like, yeah, 11. I think my checkout time is noon. I may just be like, can I get a late checkout and spend the rest of that day? Because lounging around, maybe. Or I'll check out and, you know, walk around Portland for a bit, you know, see what that's all about. I've been to SFO. It's a little airport. Fun fact, the reason Oregon and Seattle are so green compared to a lot of the surrounding areas is the same reason they created the Mojave Mountains. It's also confused the scientists to how it formed in the first place, the Rocky Mountain Range. It traps rain clouds and forces them north, blocking most moisture from Nevada air. Yep. Geology and geography. But I'll be in Orlando by that time. Oh shit, Phoenix will be in Orlando. CP Geek, how about you? And you're riding on Spirit Airways. There are several good game shops in Portland. I'm also traveling again as is my custom at this point, with no baggage. Just my shoulder bag that passes for a laptop briefcase. And getting very creative with how I roll up my clothes. So you mailed your clothes home. So, like, I'm not really shopping. I'm not buying anything that isn't, like, consumable. And I'm just... So I can just grab and go, not have to pay stupid baggage fees. Again, saving money, flying on a shoestring. And then just trying to figure out a name for if I make this a series or not, what I'm going to call it. And I thought about just being real basic with it and calling it the Introverted Traveler Series. Then I realized I could shorten it and just call it TITS. So people could sign in and look at TITS. The Introverted Traveler Series. And I was like, okay, I could take that a step further and I could try to, like, anytime something positive happens, I could be like, nice! So then that could be my slogan. And then I could put it on a t-shirt. And it'll say, nice tits! Because you're good. Yeah. Because I think it's funny. Anyway, I'm still bummed I'm missing the Don Q tasting tomorrow, all while making money and working John Fogerty. Yeah, exactly. I'd love to see John Fogerty. Going to be in Orlando starting Friday morning, off the plane at 10, boathouse reservation at 11. I don't know. We have a Don Q shortage down here, Lamp. I approve of tits. All right. There's Voodoo Donuts in Portland. That's a couple of blocks away from Union Station. So... And it's between where my hotel is and the station, so I may very well swing by there. So, I kind of like tits. Been there, and they're tasty. So, yeah, that may be something I do. We'll see. Scientists are confused by the Rockies because where they come from. Mountains are usually formed by tectonic activity. Splitting plates makes volcanoes and colliding plates make mountains ranges. The Pacific Plate and American plates are separated. That's what makes the SAF San Andreas Fault. So where the Rockies come from, the Himalayan mountains are from the India Plate budding in Asia. They suspect Ice Age glaciers now. Yeah, man, you're taking me back to Earth science class. I mean, I liked Earth science. I enjoyed it. Well... Every time I took it, that wasn't at Johnson. I liked it in high school, and I liked it at CCV. At Johnson, Earth Science can eat a hot turd. Well, specifically, Les Cannick can eat a hot turd, because fuck that guy, he's an asshole. OMG, I need to try a Voodoo Donut. Why did I go on their website? All right, so before I get sidetracked by chat again, the other thing that... I sort of wanted to wrap into this trip somehow was releasing the next Mud Season single. And there's two songs that I've been working on, and I'm still not entirely sure which of the two I want to release, but I keep leaning. I think I know. And I'm also just thinking of releasing them, like, one is the single and one's the B-side, because why not? So, I think that's... And they're both kind of songs about my dad. So, depending on what I'm able to do in the next few days, I may try to schedule I may not have enough time to get it to streaming services on Sunday, but maybe at least, you know, to come out in the next week officially. Because, I mean, I'm getting on the train on Father's Day. But. Okay. Earth facts. There's more Earth facts there. Where was I? But yeah. So I figured I'm at that point where I could keep changing and tweaking stuff forever. And I kind of just gotta push something out. So shit or get off the pot, as it were. So I'm gonna take a quick break here, and in the BRB, you're gonna get to hear what's likely gonna be the lead-off single the new 2024 Mud Season track. So I'm gonna BRB here, and we're gonna give it a listen for those that that want to give it a listen. This, where the heck is it? Lost all my stuff here. But this song is called Set in Stone. You may have seen a teaser of it on Instagram last week, maybe, or the week before. So, but yeah, I'm thinking this is our lead off single. So we're going to BRB and hope you like it. Yeah. Okay. BRB, new single time.
Set in stone. They tell me I'm the bargain version of Lil Chase Hudson, Morrissey Morrison, or the last Paul Rudson.
All right, we're back. Exclamation point play. Let's get those marbs on the board. And don't forget, exclamation point play and a number between 2 and 7 if you want a custom marb, including a brand new skin. Number 7, a baked potato. But yeah, that was set in stone. That was the super secret Twitch exclusive pre-release premiere. Cilantro. Oh, I forgot to change flavors here. Went from strawberry watermelon to orange cream. Ah, CP Geek is a potato. Oh, I suppose I should get on the board here too. Seema! Welcome in, Seema. Calling all Marb Stars, calling all Marb Stars. Get ready to roll with some marbles on stream. Get ready to roll with some marbles on stream.
Extra cheese and black olives.
Yeah, that's unlike all the other songs on this album I've been working on, that one is not something that I wrote decades ago. This one is something I wrote 2 weeks ago. It just kind of manifested out of nowhere at work one day, and I wrote it in my head. Then I got home and I made myself start recording it so I wouldn't forget it. So it lives somewhere between No Excuses by Alice in Chains and Heroes by David Bowie, I think. But yeah, so That's a thing that I made. All right, we got 8 marbs on the board. We got Crystal Lamp, Seema, Phoenix, Fates, Wadi, CB Geek, myself, and Mare Bear. Anybody else hanging out there lurking, want to jump on in? Exclamation point play like Rickshaw Tom just did. That's 9 marbs ready to roll. 9 marbs ready to roll. Well, I think that might be all of us who are currently here. So we're going to do last call before we roll. Last call. Last call. To all you absolute pros, to all you pro Marb stars, get those Marbs to the service desk. Get those Marbs to the service desk. Thank you for shopping at Ames.
Whoa. Chris Lamp just cheered 11 bits. Keep rolling, 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 rolling. Keep rolling, 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 rolling.
And now what? Too much.
Keep rolling.
And now
rolling,
that's too rolling, much.
Rolling. Keep rolling, 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 rolling.
Too much punctuation, Trashly. Well, she'll find her balance. Because, as we know from Resident Evil 4, Trashly is a, at least former gymnast. You got a gymnast? All right, let's get rolling here. Imagine that, a gymnast horse. They didn't believe it. They said, nay. They see me rolling. They hate it. I'm gonna be white and nerdy. Oh, that's an that's interesting. I don't think I've ever seen a start quite like that. Neat. It's like we're going through a couple of amphitheaters. All right, looks like, oh, your boy zooming out in the lead there. Hashtag not hacking, hashtag not rigged. Oh, Seema flying off the board, getting some Yeats of Pizza right off the bat. As the rest of us fall on into that tumble dryer. No, that's the paddle wheel of sadness. My apologies.
Whoa. CP Geek 2 just chaired 1 bits. A punctuation. Strong enough for a man. PH balanced for a slutty horse.
Oh, and Fates! Fates diving off the stage for some Yeats of Pizza and to steal that overall eighth to secure 2/3 of a hat trick there. We see what you're doing, Fates. We see what you're doing. Good, I'm hungry anyway. How you doing, Seema? Nice to see ya on this Tuesday evening. Who's currently... I think CB Geek's currently in the lead. Or is it? No, Mare Bears offers him Yeats of Pizza, as is Waddy. Oh, no, your boy's in the lead, still. All right, CB Geek's in second, Crystal Lamp third, Rickshaw Tom fourth, Phoenix currently in fifth. Oh, what the heck is this? Some kind of tube? CB Geek being like, I ain't going through that tube, heading off for some Yeats of Pizza. Oh, your boy made it through, but Rickshaw Tom, Crystal Lamp, and Phoenix have to try to navigate the tube. Oh, Crystal Lamp has navigated the tube. And look at this. We have a tumble dryer of despair inside a tumble dryer of despair. Tumble dryerception. White and Nerdy 100% replaced the original in my head. I think for a lot of folks it did. Fates out there. Yoink. If I get a fourth or Waddy gets fourth, I offer trade. Not the eat, though. That's mine. Nice, I don't have to eat alone. Oh, but your boy locking in that W because I'm allowed to win sometimes, dang it. Hashtag not hacking, hashtag not rigged. Same with the Gangster's Paradise. Amish Paradise replaced the original. I mean, it's kind of everything Weird Al has done is kind of replaced the original. I mean, I think everything... in the Angry White Boy polka he replaced. Oh, and Rickshaw Tom! Yeats of Pizza, but your boy with the W, a nice pepperoni pie just for me. Phoenix in second, Chris the Lamp in third, maybe I'll share with them, we'll see. Because everyone else gets their own Yeats of Pizza. We got Rickshaw Tom in fourth, CB Geek fifth, Waddy sixth, Mare Bear seventh, Fates already How Dared in the eighth, and Seema in ninth. Set on to race number 2, Electric Boogaloo, Glowing Alien Space. Exclamation point play. I think Beat It's better known than Eat It. Yeah. I love happy and tacky. Yeah, I mean, they also can both exist. So, and that's the beauty of it. Where the heck are we starting from? Where the heck? Oh, right in front of us. Oh, down there. All right, exclamation point play, everyone. And don't forget your custom Marb skin while you're at it. Speaking of skin, we have a delicious potato skin as well. Jack Black in the tacky music video, and even Dorking made it. Anakin guy? I don't know, does he have the high ground? Alright, we got 7 Marbs. We had 9 last time. We got CB Geek, Waddy, Phoenix, Rickshaw Tom, there's Mare Bear, Seema, Crystal Lamp, and myself. I think we're just missing Fates here. Anakin guy in American Pie. Oh, yeah. Maybe Vader someday later, but he's just a small fry. I see. CB Geek packs up and leaves Thursday night. My favorite Weird Al songs are Everything You Know Is Wrong. Black is white, up and down is short is wrong. Short is long. That's a good one, too. Amish Paradise, Foil, and Tacky. All right, anybody else hanging out lurking wants to jump on in? Exclamation point play. Otherwise, we are already a roll. Because your boy's gotta see about getting my bag packed. I'm feeling like I'm not going to. My shit's still in the washer. It's gotta go in the dryer. I also got... Oh, geez, we got a deadly laser there, and it took Chris the Lamp and Fates right off the board and off to some Yeats of Pizza. Fates in ninth, Chris the Lamp, Yeats of Pizza all the way to that eighth. And getting two-thirds of the way to a hat trick. Nothing to see here. Sure, Lamp, sure. That's what they all say. Lamp out there! When am I leaving? So, my plans changed slightly, only in that I'm not staying at an airport hotel in Hartford tomorrow night. I'm just gonna leave my house at like 4 a.m. Thursday morning. Because I leave Thursday. Thursday is my biggest travel day. Because I drive to Hartford, then fly to Atlanta, then fly to Denver, then fly to Portland. And that's where I get my next sleep. Oh, your boy was in the lead, but then Mare Bear flew on ahead. Looks like Mare Bear is going to finish first. Maybe. Oh, nope. There's more to the course here. Oh, looks like it's me and Mare Bear racing to see who's going to finish first. Oh, no, but Phoenix out of nowhere jumping on in there. Oh, but we got a little paddling here. Phoenix, though. Now it's Phoenix and Mare Bear who's gonna pull off the victory. I love how foil goes from average cooking commercial to tea tinfoil hat conspiracy. Oh, we got another deadly laser here, though. You got to watch out. We got a bunch more deadly lasers. Oh, and speaking of deadly lasers, your boy just hit one. Joining Lamp and Fates for some Yeats of Pizza. Oh, Mare Bear and Waddy joining us for some Yeats of Pizza. It's okay, Mare Bear. We all finish early sometimes. But Phoenix is holding on to the lead, holding on for one more day. Oh, flying right past that spinneroony. But we got some deadly lasers to contend with. Can Phoenix survive the deadly lasers and get that W? Oh, Phoenix does scoots right on around. Oh, but here comes Seema with a head full of steam for the upset. Oh, but Phoenix pulling it off, making it happen. Seema overshooting the landing for some more Yeats of Pizza. I hope you have a safe and awesome trip. I do too. I'll do my best. But I'll be doing a short stream from Seattle on Friday. And then I'll be streaming from Chicago on Tuesday. But Phoenix with a W, Rickshaw Tom second, everyone else Yeats of Pizza, Waddy third, Chris the Lamp fourth. Oh wait, is it doing that thing again? It is doing that thing again. Isn't it? Because Lamp got eighth, didn't he? It's doing the thing again. Ugh. Ugh. All right, well, I guess we're gonna have to wait till the end to see where people actually... Yeah. Lamp stole eighth without permission! All right, exclamation point play, folks. To get on the board for Slow Bumsy. Whatever that means. Oh, we gotta take the hat off. That would be bad luck. Well, I was worried about the stream holding up, but now we have... No, we didn't drop any frames, so... I guess maybe it was Discord that was just having issues. I'll take it. Did you figure out how you're going to time your stream in Seattle to East Coast time? So... It's going to be on the earlier end, but like, I mean, my stated stream start time is 8, although I rarely ever start at 8, but that's what I'm going to be gunning for, because that'll be 5 o'clock Pacific time. And I believe my train back is like 6 something. So I'll probably... So for time here, it's going to be pretty close to that 8 o'clock normal start time. So... Yeah, keep your eyes on your notifications. All right, we got 8. We're missing 1. Who are we missing here? We got Crystal Lamp, Waddy, Fates, Seema, Mare Bear, Phoenix, myself, and CP Geek. Looks like we're missing Rickshaw Tom. No, we haven't seen On You May tonight. Ha 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 ha! That's Mandark. Ha 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 ha! For people that know what that is, I'm Mandark. Paging Rickshaw Tom for race number 3. Paging Rickshaw Tom. Oh, there you are. All right, let's get rolling. It is 11:22. 2 more races to go. And then a guided raid out to DJ Nikki.
It's Dexter's Laboratory.
Whoa, where the heck we go? All right, flying down in an obscured Plinko board. Then we're going to roll down some steps here. All right, Waddy leading the charge on the right-hand side. Crystal Lamp leading the charge on the left-hand side. World record on this course, 2 minutes, 16 seconds. And Waddy just barely having a lead there. But Crystal Lamp somehow scooting way into the lead. Zippity-zop zoom. Oh, but Phoenix hot on Lamp's tail. Mare Bear hot on Waddy's tail.
Lol. Didi, get out of my laboratory!
Okay!
I am not Grandpa!
Okay, Grandpa!
Maybe I should finish what I started with that Darth Vader fight. We're neck and neck here with Phoenix and Crystal Lamp. Phoenix, though, ducking out ahead of Crystal Lamp. But Crystal Lamp back in the lead. Anything can happen when you're playing marbles on stream. Lamp wanted to know how much longer you went after he left last night. All right, Chris currently in the lead. Phoenix second, Mare Bear third. Now Mare Bear out of nowhere jumping into the lead. Stampeding for the finish. Crystal Lamp in second. Phoenix went the other way. I don't think that gamble's going to pay off. It's Mare Bear versus Lamp here. Who's gonna hit that finish line first?
Mare Bear out of nowhere!
And it's Mare Bear, first to the finish line. Crystal Lamp in second. CB Geek third, Rickshaw Tom fourth. Waddy fifth, your boy sixth. Phoenix seventh. I didn't quite see who hit the eighth, though. And it's not... Oh, now it's telling us. Fates stole the overall eighth again, and Seema in ninth.
No, Fates out there.
All right, well, we're on to the penultimate race, number 4 out of 5. Amazing, crazy adventure. Hey, that's what I'm going to have. Exclamation point play. Man, everybody getting those pizza marbs. Well, not everybody, but... Two eighths and two yeets. Nice. Waddy, just get a fourth and you get an eighth if you want to trade. All right, we got seven Marbs on the board. That means we're missing two. All right, we got Phoenix, myself, Waddy, Lamp, CB Geek, Seema, and Fates. I am a potato. My beatboxing blueberry. Baka, 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 baka. All right, we got Mare Bear, exclamation point, play sex. Yay, I wins! All right, we're missing one. Who are we missing here?
Whoa, Mare Bear Panda Booty just cheered one bits. Woot woot, I wins.
Well done, Mare Bear. I think we're just missing Rickshaw Tom again. I kind of get confuzzled sometimes. I'm not really into IRL romance, yet I read rom-coms.
Thomas!
Well, some of my favorite comedy movies happen to also be rom-coms, so, like, there's nothing wrong with the genre. A lot of musical theater, if you think about it, is romantic comedy. Like, an absolutely underrated gem from when me and Tom were in high school is a movie called Say It Isn't So. Oh my god, it's so fucking funny. But it's technically a rom-com. I unironically like The Wedding... Yeah, I like The Wedding Singer, too. It was one of my mom's favorite movies. Then you are going into the oven to be buttered, salt, and peppered. Oh, I didn't even notice the typo, Mare Bear. Mom had an abundance of just romance stuff. Twilight, abundance of Catherine's, etc. I mean, it's a huge industry. It really is. All right, Rickshaw Tom's on the board, so let's get rolling. Then we got one more race after this.
Hey, Linda! You a bitch!
Alright, we got Phoenix leading the charge. It's hard to see where everyone else is, though, as we go through this. Lime green with a rainbow interior flavored Twizzler. Oh, now your boy's in the lead. Hashtag not hacking, hashtag not rigged. Oh, that didn't last long. Now Mare Bear is out in the lead again, trying to show us up by finishing first on multiple occasions. Oh, well, we got a cluster there. We got a cluster, but Mare Bear recovers. Holding on. Holding on for one more day. All right, we got Mare Bear and Fates going that way. CB Geek going the high road. No one going through the middle. Interesting. Well, it looks like the middle is not the best one to take. A lot more obstacles and risk the chance of getting pegged in there, too. So probably best to not. All right, going through the rainbow labyrinth into the rainbow paddle wheel of sadness. Mare Bear, though. Oh, no. Going right through the middle of the pegboard. Waddy, though, going around the outside. Mare Bear sticks the landing, though, takes that pegging like a champ. Waddy, though, in first place. Fates holding on to that second place. Now we got CB Geek and Mare Bear tied for third. I remember watching The Host gave me nightmares, face huggers fall off, but Ghost Aliens doing a Men in Black 2 and Body Snatch? That nightmare fuel. I'd honestly prefer genocidal aliens since I have the luxury of dying and resting in peace.
It just takes some time, little girl, you're in the middle of the ride.
At least I hope that's what you're referencing. This looks like it's going to take 1 million years. Well, world record on this is 2 minutes 27 seconds. There's not too much further to go, but they had a lot of stupid steps. All right, but Waddy going around the outside again and making it through that paddle wheel. Looks like it's Waddy's race to lose. W could stand for Waddy, folks. We're about to find out. Could it be so? Could it be so? It is. W stands for Waddy, folks. Read it and weep. Here comes Fates. Managed to hold on to that sexy silver the whole time. Well done. This isn't the stairway to heaven. It's the highway to hell. And Phoenix in third. Here comes your boy in fourth. CB Geek fifth. Mare Bear in sex. Chris the Lamp in seventh. And Rickshaw Tom cheekily, obviously, glaringly taking that 8th place. Knew you'd pick up what I was throwing down. That's just how I roll. Tom Powder! And here comes Seema rounding things out. And I think this is the first race of this Grand Prix where we've all finished. But W stands for Audi, folks. I don't make the rules. I just announce them. All right, moving on to the last race here. The last race. Last call. Last call. Last race on Marbles on Stream. Exclamation point play. Let's get those marbs on the board. Oh, yeah.
Whoa.
Thanks for shopping,
Fates. We just cheered one bit. Yay, what we I.
What we I. Yeah, what we I. World record on this is 2 minutes flat. So exclamation point play. You don't want to miss out on the final race of this Grand Prix. Because also, we may not be able to play Marbs on our Seattle stream on Friday. It may just be an IRL cell phone stream. We'll see, though. We'll see. But, yeah. It's probably a little more likely for the Chicago stream next Tuesday. But, again, we'll see. This may be our last Marbs for a week and a half. Until next Friday. Did you say sixth or six? I said German for six. I would just answer yes if I did that and got asked. Just got through the part of Spider-Man where Miles loses his dad. Makes me wonder if he'll be able to save him in Spider-Verse.
Oh my.
All right, we got our 9 marbs on the board. Last call here. Anyone else that wants in? But I think it's just us. I think it's just us. So let's get rolling. Hi, my wife, my family, and I are looking for sex.
Whomp.
All right, what's German for six? Sex, Dad. Grow up, Audrey. No, Dad, it's German for six. That's from National Lampoon's European Vacation, if anyone was curious. I mean, I got sexy silver, so close enough. Absolutely. It's more important for you to have a new adventure. Thanks. If I can, Marb, I will. Oh, Fates! That would have been an epic shortcut, but just couldn't stick the landing. Fate's getting one final slice of Yeetza Pizza. Ah, we got the gross shark again. CB Geek stealing that overall 8th and some slices of Yeetza Pizza. Great gold, sexy silver, and bold bronze. It's more like glorious gold, sexy silver, and LeBron's James. is a hard one to follow. Oh, there's an invisible obstacle. What the heck? Oh, that's stupid. Oh, that's why no one's getting any further. Oh, I think Rickshaw Tom did. Rickshaw Tom could be the savior, but he's heading right towards that shark's mouth. You know, you go in one end, you don't come out the same end. So, after a horrible adventure through the digestive tract, Rickshaw Tom has moved on from the ninja obstacle to the shark obstacle, back to the marbstacle. Oh, but Waddy has moved through too. Here comes Phoenix. All right.
CB Geek out there.
All right, Phoenix now in the lead, but Waddy very close behind in second. It could be a 2-for-2 for Waddy. Again, W could stand for Waddy. You never know. I don't make the rules. One bite, everybody knows the rules. And Waddy's back in the lead. Just got a pop-up ad for one of those mice that looks like a piece of paper given to a kid with a hole puncher. I don't even know what that is. But what I do know is that W stands for Waddy, folks. Phoenix second, Rickshaw Tom in third. Here comes Seema for fourth. Oh, Mare Bear just missing out on the sex this time around. Looks like that's going to Chris the Lamp. Oh, but here come the Flames of Oblivion. Chris the Lamp better hurry up. Oh, and your boy's up there too. I better hurry up. Oh, those. Yeah. Okay, I know what you're talking about now. Yeah, the super, super lightweight ones. No thanks. Oh, and your boy offer some Yeats of Pizza. Thanks to the Flames of Oblivion, as is Chris the Lamp. But Waddy going 2-for-2 the last two races with the W's. Phoenix second, Rickshaw Tom third, Seema fourth, Mare Bear in fifth. Chris the Lamp sixth, your boy seventh, CB Geek getting How Dared in eighth. And Fates rounding things out with the Yeats of Pizza Clan. But let's head on over to Victory Valley, see who stands tall, stands proud, goes home with all the gold, glory, and bragging rights, because we ain't over yet.
It's the final countdown!
I don't know what happened right there. We had a network problem. All right, in third place, though, going home with the bronze, we've got Rickshaw Tom. And in second place, going home with silver, sexy silver, is none other than Waddy! The final W didn't stand for Waddy this time, despite the two W's. Who could have possibly done better? Well, it is a points battle, and who succeeded in the points battle? Well, it's none other than the most
excellent
Phoenix, rising from the ashes and making it count where it counts most. 106 massive points, 1 W. Phoenix putting us all to shame. Waddy in second, 73-2. Rickshaw Tom third, 51-0. Lamp in fourth, 34-0. Your boy in fifth, 29-1. Fates in sixth, 22-0. Mare Bear seventh, 18-1. CB Geek stealing that overall eighth as well with 12-0. And Seema, we're just happy you're here. Zillow and Zammo rounding things out.
CB Geek, how dare overall?
Wait, I was going to complain, but I got sixth. Isn't that a win for me? Yeah. But of course, we are all winners, and we are all
excellent
on this blessed day. So a round of applause for everyone. Dang, your computer crashed. Grrr. Aw. Well, at least you were here, Seema. At least you were here. At least we were all here. Because the next time we will all be here, Well, we won't be here. I will be on the West Coast and somewhere in Seattle, probably close to the train station. And then, yeah. And that'll be our Friday stream. And I'll let you know how the trip is going so far. I'm hoping it goes well. But it is now time for us to raid on out, because Waddy did redeem guiding the old Raider-Rooney here. Have a wonderful trip. I will do my absolute best. Let me get this raid queued up here. I hate how they changed the dang thing here. Let's see, where are ya?
Remember, did you pay?
Is there, with this new stupid... Oh, wait. It's way down there, isn't it? Okay, there we go. I hate it at all times. All right, well, again, everybody have a fantastic night. And if you follow me on socials, you can keep up to date on my travel escapades as they happen. Hopefully everything goes smooth and seamless. But again, thank you all for being here. Thanks for humoring me and listening to my new song. I hope it wasn't too offensive. I hope it wasn't too... unpolished. I don't know. It is what it is. But we are going to raid on over to the birthday boy, DJ Nikki G. So bring all the hype, bring all the loves over there. And other than that, all I got to do is say so long and good night. Oh.
Whoa.
Got to wait for Trashly first.
Booty just cheered one bit.
But who
have a great trip, Harris.
It's not about
take lots of pictures. Be safe.
I will.
Love you.
Ooh. So long and good night.